Iron deficiency could manifest itself in the form of subtle symptoms like weakness, fatigue, pale skin or dizziness, or also in the form of conditions like anemia, where there is a serious reduction in your hemoglobin and red blood cell count. In this video, I am going to tell you what causes iron deficiency in our body, ways in which you can increase the absorption of iron from foods, and top iron-rich foods in India. If you are interested, keep watching. Hello everyone, this is Nirupama and welcome to Simplify. I make videos on food, health and nutrition. If these kind of videos interest you, do consider subscribing to my channel. Let's get started with what are the major causes of iron deficiency in our body. The first cause is insufficient intake of iron-rich foods. Some of the best iron-rich foods are seafood, poultry, and red meat, especially liver. The iron in these foods is called the heme iron, which is absorbed very efficiently by our body. That is why non-vegetarians or meat eaters usually do not have a problem of iron deficiency. Now in India, vast majority of people follow a vegetarian diet. Vegetarian foods also have enough iron in them, but things get a little tricky here because the iron in vegetarian foods, called the non-heme iron, is not absorbed very well by our body. So the solution for vegetarians is to include a variety of iron-rich foods in the diet to compensate for the low iron absorption from these plant-based foods. The second cause of iron deficiency is insufficient absorption of iron. So let's say you make sure to include a lot of iron-rich foods in your diet, but eating all these iron-rich foods is pointless if only a very small percentage of iron is actually getting absorbed by the body. The third reason for low iron levels in the body is hookworm infestation or malaria, which are quite common in a tropical country like India. In this video, I'll be telling you how to tackle iron deficiency occurring due to the first two causes. Let's first look at how we can increase the absorption of iron from foods we eat. It is pointless to eat all iron-rich foods if hardly any iron is getting absorbed by the body. This is especially true for non-heme iron from plant-based foods. So what can we do to tackle this problem? The first thing that we can do is to include more iron enhancers in our diet. Iron enhancers, as the name suggests, are foods that helps in better absorption of iron. Vitamin C containing foods are excellent iron enhancers. So as an example, you can include foods like lemon, amla or tomatoes in the form of pickles or salad along with iron-rich foods. This will help boost the absorption of iron from your food. The second thing that we can do is to avoid iron inhibitors with our meals. Iron inhibitors are foods that block the absorption of iron. Teas and coffees have a compound called tannins, which act as iron inhibitors. So I would recommend you to not have tea or coffee with your meals. Instead, have them at least an hour or two before or after your meals. Similarly, too much calcium can act as iron inhibitor. So it is recommended to not have high calcium foods like milk or calcium supplements along with iron-rich foods. The third tip is to soak, cook, and germinate. Legumes, beans, or nuts are good sources of iron, but they also contain something called phytates, which blocks the absorption of iron. Soaking, cooking, or germination are processes that reduce the level of phytates in legumes, beans, and nuts, and therefore help in better absorption of iron. So these three tips will definitely help you absorb iron better from the foods that you eat. Time to now look at some of the top iron-rich foods in India. These foods should be included by everybody, especially vegetarians, in your diet if you're looking to increase your iron levels or just to maintain good iron levels in the body. The first food category are legumes or pulses. These are a great source of iron. Some of the best legumes to boost your iron level are red kidney beans or rajma, black gram or urad, chickpeas or chole, and black chickpea or kala chana. As I mentioned earlier, it is important to soak, germinate, and cook these legumes really well, as the process of soaking, germination, cooking reduces the level of phytates in these legumes and enhances the absorption of iron in them. The second iron-rich food on my list is the banana flour. Banana flour has outstanding medicinal properties, which is unfortunately not very well known. It is an excellent source of iron and is mentioned in Ayurveda for managing iron deficiency. If you do get your hands on banana flour, make sure to understand how to use it and cook it for getting maximum benefits out of it. The third iron-rich food on my list is beetroot. Beetroot has a decent amount of iron in it, and it also has the minerals vitamin C and folic acid. Vitamin C helps in better absorption of the iron in beetroot, while folic acid helps in formation of RBCs in blood. This combination of minerals in beetroot makes it ideal for fighting iron deficiency and anemia in our body. In fact, beetroot juice combined with jaggery has been shown to be effective in fighting anemia in adolescent girls in India. The fourth iron-rich food on my list is finger millet or ragi. Ragi is a good source of iron along with having a lot of other nutritional benefits. A few community studies have shown malted ragi porridge or ragi kanji to be effective in improving iron levels in the body. Ragi also has low level of phytates, which helps in easy absorption of the iron in ragi. The fifth iron-rich food on my list is sesame seeds or til. Sesame seeds or til are a good source of iron, and they are known to improve blood hemoglobin. To get maximum benefits, sesame seeds should either be roasted or soaked before consumption. The sixth iron-rich foods on my list are green leafy vegetables. As you might already know, green leafy vegetables are the best source of iron. Some of the best leafy vegetables to have are spinach or palak, arbi ke patte or colocasia leaves, fenugreek or methi, and mustard greens or sarso saag. It is best to cook these leafy greens instead of having them raw, as cooking reduces the level of phytates in these vegetables and makes the iron more absorbable. Also, try to complement your green leafy vegetables with vitamin C rich foods, as vitamin C further enhances the absorption of iron from these vegetables. The seventh iron rich food on my list is jaggery and black raisins. Jaggery and black raisins definitely deserve a mention because they are good sources of iron. However, it is important to keep in mind that be it jaggery, black raisins, or any of the other foods that I mentioned today, it is recommended to not overeat any of these foods in hope of high iron levels. The idea is to make a variety of foods part of your daily diet and eat them the right way to ensure adequate iron intake. Another bonus tip is to start using iron kadhais or iron tawas for cooking your food. It has been shown that food cooked in iron utensils has more iron than food cooked in non-iron utensils. So you might want to consider buying some iron cookware and start cooking your food in them right away. Before wrapping up the video, a quick tip on iron supplements. Of course, iron supplements are a quick way of increasing blood iron levels, but you must remember that iron supplements only work when the iron levels in your body are extremely low. In other cases, a simple diet change helps fix the problem. So the best way forward is to get a blood test and consult a doctor if your iron levels are outside the recommended range. That's all from me for today's video. I hope you found the video useful. If you did, do let me know in the comments. I would love to know. I'll see you guys in my next video. Take care until then. Bye.